I'm going to call them frenemies. That's a good way to describe that relationship.
That's too nice, actually.
All right, well, Skip Bayless, here's the question.
Yes, ma'am.
What do you make of it if it's too nice?
Carrie, Stephen A.
Yeah.
This is what I make of this. Tom Brady is now officially scared of T-Sizzle. And I'm not overstating this because you know that I've got to know Terrell Suggs very well from the battles that we've had on this show repeatedly over time. And I'm here to tell you that he utterly despises Tom Brady. Everything about Tom Brady, as he's spoken on other shows, even down to his hair. He doesn't like Tom Brady's hair. And it's not an act on T-Sizzle's part. He just deeply despises everything New England, and he, to your point about the Tuck Rule game, he feels like that launched unfairly a dynasty, and that Spygate continued the dynasty in ways that it shouldn't have been allowed to continue. So he despises everything New England. And I'm here to remind you, the Baltimore Ravens should have won the last three times they played playoff games in Foxborough against Tom Brady. The middle game, you remember, it went to the buzzer, went to the wire, and Lee Evans missed a pass that was right in his hands. Then Billy Cundiff missed a chip shot field goal that would have taken it to overtime. The Ravens, I sat here right on First Take the next day and said, boy, the Ravens did everything but win that football game. So my point is that Tom Brady has finally, and he despises T-Sizzle too, but Tom Brady has finally given up psychologically and said, I'm not going to give this man any more ammunition. He's already good enough as he is. I'm going to play nice with gritted teeth, as we saw yesterday. He was gritting his teeth and trying to smile because he fears what Mr. Suggs has done to him in three straight playoff games in the house that he built in Foxborough. So he's basically saying, I'm sorry, I'm afraid of him. I'm afraid of what he can become. I'm not going to rattle the cage, so to speak. I'm not going to relight the fire. I'm going to give him zero ammunition to get further motivated to come in and torment me again. Because the biggest tormentor to Tom Brady has been this man. And he uses all of his hatred of everything New England to propel him after Tom Brady, down after play after down after play. And as Tom said yesterday, it doesn't even matter what the defense called is. This guy smells out the play, breaks the defense, and makes the play, especially against New England. So I think it took every ounce of Tom Brady's pride to back off yesterday and play completely nice when that's not how he feels about Mr. Suggs.
I respectfully disagree with you because I think you're being a bit extreme. You can have a healthy and appreciable respect for somebody without fearing them. It's called competition. And when you are elite, you respect somebody who's elite. It's not fearing them. It's recognizing, yo, this brother can play. I've got to bring my A game because I know I'm going to have to deal with him. When Tom Brady lost in the Super Bowl, not once, but twice to the New York Giants in a span of 4 to 5 years, I had the luxury of speaking, whether it be to Michael Strahan after 2007, Justin Tuck, Jason Pierre-Paul, and those boys, and they talked about how they were putting a hat on Tom Brady all day long, and they were really socking it to him. And they talked about how Tom Brady was cussing out his offensive lineman, getting in everybody's face, but how they walked away from that game with even more respect for him than they had ever had because they viewed him as some pretty boy that was getting all the acclaim, all the headlines, etc. And when they went out there on that football field, what they went against was a football player. They went against a guy that wasn't encouraging them to back down. He was encouraging them to bring it. He was just on his offensive line to make sure that they brought it too. This is Tom Brady we're talking about here. So I'm telling you, the guy that you know is great, that is a future Hall of Famer, I'm respectfully saying to you, it is incredibly disrespectful to sit there and say, he is scared of T-Sizzle. No, you are going too far. Now, let me also say this. When T-Sizzle has the acrimony, the feelings, the negative feelings that he may have for Tom Brady, let's take this a step deeper and call it what it is. Tom Brady is everything T-Sizzle will never be. Okay? T-Sizzle is blue collar, rough rider, I mean, I love the brother, but let's be honest. He will never be accused for being the prettiest dude in the world.
He's not
just not going to be that dude, all right? And that's fine with him. But Tom Brady, you got the money. You got the franchise. Mm-hmm. You got the headlines.
You got the
woman.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And my God, the wardrobe.